from the Lord. But many of us, when we are beginning to receive bad things, when you are going through hard time in life, we begin to question God. What sin did I commit that I deserve this punishment? What have I done against you, Lord, that I'm going through this? And through that, depression will come upon your life. Spirit of heaviness will come upon your life. When the devil is tempting you, you need to stand your ground and declare that I refuse to be depressed. I refuse to be disconnected from my Maker. I refuse to be disconnected from the Spirit of God. Our Baba preached from the same message. Depression is not a good thing. When you are depressed, you are angry with everyone. You don't want to see anyone smiling. You don't want to see anyone happy. You want to transfer your depression to everyone. You are always angry. Write this down. You need more muscles to frown than to smile. Tell your neighbor, you need more muscles to frown than to smile. If you ever see someone depressed, maybe when you're depressed, you never went to the mirror. When you are frowning, you see the veins in the neck. You see the veins in the head. When someone is angry, the veins are all over. You need more veins to frown than to smile. When you're always frowning, when you're always angry, you look older than yourself. You look older than your age. You don't lose anything by smiling. Don't let the devil bring depression upon your life. When you're going through a situation, just know the devil is trying to bring depression upon your life. When you are depressed, you can't sleep. When you are depressed, even your mind doesn't function well. You don't think proper. Even the things that you say out of your mouth is just to depress everyone around you. If you ever see someone angry, when you smile with them, they become more angry. Why are you smiling? What is there to smile about? They want you to feel, they want you to bring you where they are. They want you to feel what they are feeling. But it's not your portion. Our life must not be directed by people around us. You see, in Namibia, it's very easy to be depressed. Early in the morning, you can be depressed by a taxi driver. You just started your day on your way to work. You know our brothers, how they drive. You are driving to work, you are worshipping. He cut you off. You are angry. What is he doing? This stupid man. This depression is coming. By the time you get to your work, the boss is also waiting for you. Because the devil has already started with the taxi driver. So now everything is in line for him to ruin your day. Now your day is wasted. Just because of people. I always say, if you blame people around you for the depression that you're going through, you are wasting your time. As a child of God, you need to come to a point where you are not moved by anyone, where you are not moved by any insult, where you are not moved by anything that the person around you will say. Because the devil will not come before you and tempt you. He always uses the people around you. I always say, everyone that you have met in life is an angel for you. Whether that person was a good person or a bad person, through the experience, you have learned something through your relationship with them. You have learned something. That with these kind of people, I need to deal with them this way. I don't need to give them more room in my life. I need to treat them this way. So don't blame anyone that has made me angry. Don't blame everyone that has disappointed you in the past. You have learned something out of that relationship. Amen. Where yourself. Work on your spiritual life. Work on your mentality. The way you think. The people, you see why it's called betrayal? Because it's not done by someone far. It's done by someone close to you. Someone that you are not expecting to do that for you. It pays to be happy. It pays to smile. Me, the industry that I am, is a tough one. You deal with different kind of people. That if you are not careful, you will die young because of stress. I have learned a lot in that industry. Graphic designing. I have learned a lot. I have learned patience with people. People will tell you this is what I want. You will do exactly what they want. They will tell you, I never said that. You are wasting my time. I can go anywhere. That's people for you. People will never treat you how you treat them. So if you are, wake up one day and say, I've decided to be kind to everyone today. From today, I want to be kind to everyone. I want to treat everyone good. Don't expect them to treat you the same. Don't expect them to treat you the same. People will disappoint you when you're not expecting it. You need more muscles to frown than to smile. Amen. Depression is a basis for destruction of life because it kills. Let me read it again. Depression is a basis for the destruction of life because it kills. When depression comes upon your life, you are headed for destruction. The words that you say when you're depressed, they are not holy. They are not friendly. So when depression comes upon your life, the only direction that you're going is destruction. Is destruction. Many people, they backslided because of depression. They begin to ask themselves, so if I'm a child of God, why am I going through this? They don't read their Bibles. Look at the men of God in the Bible, what they went through before they become who they are today. Being born again, being a child of God, it doesn't mean you are free from the devil. It doesn't mean you are free from the evil spirit. It doesn't mean you are free from sickness. They will come, but we have overcome them through Jesus Christ. We are victorious through Jesus Christ. If Jesus was like you and me, he could have fallen into depression because of the people around him, because of the people who are coming into his ministry. They will come and criticize him. You think you are a son of God. Are you not Joseph's son? The son of a carpenter. Now you are calling yourself a prophet. They will come to you. And you, are you the one who was born in the village? Where do you think you are going? Who do you think you are? You call yourself a child of God. What is there to show that you're a child of God? What is changing in your life? Depression. 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 What brings divorce today is depression. What brings divorce today is depression. No one wants to fight for the marriage. Every person wants to fight for himself. You are frustrated because what your spouse is doing. You are frustrated. You say there is no way in this marriage. I always say marriage involves three things. It's you and your spouse and marriage on its own. So when you're going through a certain challenge with your spouse, know that there is a relationship between you and that relationship is called marriage. So instead of you fighting for yourself and say I am right, you are wrong. Fight for your marriage. Apologize even when you are right. That is Spirit of God. But that is the thing that we are lacking in our life today. When there is a fight, everyone wants to fight for himself, not for the relationship. The relationship is crying, fight for me. If you fight for me, at the end there shall be peace. But if you fight for yourself, at the end there shall be depression. After depression, destruction, the marriage is gone. What are you fighting for in life? Do you fight for yourself? If Jesus was fighting for himself, depression was going to come upon his life. But Jesus never fought for himself. He never fought for himself. He knew who he was. He knew God will fight for me. God will fight my battles. That is the level that you must come, children. When they are accusing you, don't begin to defend yourself. Because through defending yourself, you are going to say things that you are not supposed to say. Then you go into more troubles. Focus on God. They say I did this. And I know I did not do it. And my God knows I did not do it. So why should I worry? Time will tell. Amen. There is no lie that will last forever. There is no accusation that will last forever. Amen. The truth will always speak. Amen. On his own time, the truth will always speak. Amen. So don't waste your time and defend yourselves before people. Let God fight for your battles. Amen. Tell your neighbor, don't fight for yourself. Don't fight for yourself. Let God fight for you. Write this down. What you do not kill can kill you. Amen. What you do not kill will kill you. Amen. My brother, my sister, if you don't kill that depression,
yes,
it will kill you.
Oh, yes.
If you don't kill that anger,
oh, yes,
it will kill you.
Oh, yes.
Whatever you don't kill, it will kill you. You see, there are people who say, maybe that is how God made me.